Hello there, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to another episode of Shaun Builds a Blank. Now, fair warning, I don't actually know what I'm going to be building this week because I'm kind of going to leave things up to chance and just hope that by random selection of these roller coasters that I pick something that I have not yet built before. Oh, let me make that a little bit smaller. Okay, so what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to close my eyes while doing kind of a circular or jagged thing like that. And I'm going to click something and we're going to build it, okay? So here we go. 1, 2, 3. Okay, apparently we are building a Giovanola Hyper coaster. There are only two of these in the world right now, and ever, because Giovanola is actually out of business. So this right here should be pretty interesting, actually. And that's not nearly enough cars for what this has. I think Goliath has like 5 or something. So I'm gonna need a ton of space, just ridiculous amounts of space. I'm not gonna lie, I was hoping that I wasn't going to get this. I was hoping I was gonna get like stand-up coaster or wing coaster. I can build those. I can build this, but I mean, why? But you know what? If that's what it picks, that's what it gets. Alright, so I'm going to start that off right there. That should be good, but the station's not big enough yet, because we need about that many. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Cool, that is good. Now, I'm going to turn off angle snap now, because all these rides start out the same way. And they all start with a very, very small turn out of the station, and I'm going to add a slight slope to this. They don't have slopes, but the physics in this game are kind of wonky, so I feel like I need one. Alright, so there's that. Now I'm going to add friction brakes. And how's that looking? Actually, I'm going to have it go a little bit more. I'm going to go ahead and turn back on angle snap. And there should be good. There should be good. And add some drive tires, because I think that there are drive tires on Goliath. This may actually be the wrong type of drive tires. I think it has the vertical tires. This is just me getting nerdy. Also, this is very, very B&M of them to have that underneath it. But I'm not going to fault them for it, because you know what? It's such a minor detail that I just don't care. Okay, now let's start with the lift hill. What degree is this? 33.75. That should be alright. And I'm going to set that large. And we're going to get up to about 230 feet. What am I at? 358. This is not a giga coaster. This is a hyper coaster. So I'm going to calm that down to about there. And in most circumstances right here, I would actually reduce this. Actually, no, I will still reduce it to about that. What am I at? 260. That's fine, and we'll add that to it, and this drop isn't going to be very exciting because it's a Giovanola and they're not exciting, so let's go to about there, and yeah, 65 is as steep as this can go. That's actually extremely accurate, because this is how steep Goliath's drop really is. And that's obviously not very steep for a hyper coaster at all. It's actually one of my main gripes with Goliath, is that like Like, you go down the drop and you're like, this is it. This is what we've been waiting for. And yeah, that's all you get. Alright, now let's start heading up into the mid-course. And yeah, 60, I'll keep it at about this. 172, yeah, that should be good. And we'll start banking you around. Now these turns right here are flat. This is actually kind of a bit different from what they actually do, but I have decided that it's fine because I'm the one building it, and that's just how it works. I have the final say, and now we're gonna go there, and we're gonna head into a ridiculously drawn out air hill. Alright, now right about here, we need to start heading into a mid-course section. And this right here is where I can kind of start to add some variation to it, because Titan at Six Flags Over Texas actually has a double helix in this section, so I don't know if I want to add that or not. Kind of would be kind of cool. Also, I'm way farther away from the lift than I would actually want, because they usually hug the lift at about probably this mark, but obviously I'm really far away from it, and that's because this did end up a bit different than how it actually is, and that's my bad. Oops. But yeah, I think I will add the helix going up. Now, what is my angle snap at? I'm actually gonna set that to 0. And we'll start having you go that way. I'll have it so that it's at least pointing towards the lift. I don't know why I couldn't think of the word lift. You know, the uppy bit. I have to have it heading towards the uppy bit. And there we go. Now, if I want to go true Six Flags fashion, I would actually just have this thing stop completely on here. But I'm not going to, because I don't really understand why they do that. I will have it at its full length, though. Its full girth, if you will. Now, alright, that right there is good. If I actually had the right-hand side catwalk, I think it actually would touch the glyph just barely. So, you know what? I'm cool with that. That's great. Now we're gonna have you start banking down. Start banking you that way. And for those of you wondering what my opinion on Giovanola Hyper coasters are, I think that they suck. Okay? Like, I don't like them. I wish that Goliath was a far, far better hyper coaster than what it is. because I think it's a bit pathetic. Like, it's like there's like maybe two moments of airtime, and that's being really generous. I can only bank it to 75. Okay. Goliath has an overbank turn, so that's kind of strange. That's what I was trying to build right here, was the overbank turn, but I guess it's not gonna let me do that. Huh. Interesting. What's my banking at? Zero. Okay, that's good. Okay, there we go. I'm at this level. That looked bad. Let's go that way, and then like that. And I'm gonna clicky on that, and I'll smooth it out. Yeah, it's probably because you want to overbank, isn't it? Yeah, because you should be overbanking. It's like it's yelling at me, please, just let me overbank. I'm like, I'm sorry, the game will literally not let you overbank. This part right here, I really want to get... Won't let me. Why? It doesn't make sense. How about now? Oh my god, thank you. That's all I wanted. That's literally all that I wanted. And let me start testing this thing, because I don't know if this thing's gonna work. Oh, also I wanted today's video to be a Busch Gardens video, but I started trying to build something and I was just getting frustrated. So I stopped, so that's why you don't have a Busch Gardens video. Because I'm really, really, really stuck. And it sucks, and I don't want to be stuck, but... At least I found a way to get a video out. I've actually been kind of working on the Cedar Fair Park a bit more. I mean, obviously you saw that I built a wing coaster, but I've kind of been working on like theming the area around it. I've been watching a lot of other Planet Coaster YouTubers trying to get inspired. And one of the hard things about watching other people like do videos of the same game that you play is, either one of two things is gonna happen. You're either gonna get really, really inspired, or you're just gonna look at it and be like, wow, I suck. And I'm kind of in the middle of that right now. Like, if I watch Silverette or anyone like that, then I immediately think that with my theming, I suck. However, with my coaster building, I think that I'm like, this is gonna sound really, really pretentious, but I think that I'm one of the better coaster builders out there, because I am a coaster enthusiast, so, like, I know how things are supposed to look. I know what, like, the general style is for those rides. And Silverette is obviously also a coaster enthusiast with the way that he, talks about some of the things that he builds. Like, he knows what an RMC is quite well, actually. And I actually just want to watch and see how it goes into that. Yep. Alright, that's fine. It's not letting me smooth it much, but that's fine. But anyways, like, the way that he's able to theme things and just think so out of the box, like, it's almost difficult for me to build like that, because I'm just so stuck in, like, I don't know, like, I guess my old ways of building things, and like RCT2, and I guess to a certain degree also 3. Like, I never really got too much into the custom scenery bit. Like, With one of my RCT2 parks, I did get sort of into it, and that was with my Rad Adventures parks, which was, I mean, basically just my own chain of theme parks that me and my best friend Mike would build. And I do hope that once he actually gets a proper PC going, that we will play Planet Coaster together and just kind of trade the park back and forth. And we will build another Rad Adventure style park, but I don't know when that's going to happen. And I can't force him to build a PC. It's kind of expensive to build a PC. And I was actually thinking about upgrading parts of this one this year, but I don't think that's going to happen anymore because I've had to put money towards other things like bills and such, and that does take priority over me just building a new PC for the hell of it, because I want to be able to play better games. But I, for what it's worth, like, this thing does, my current build does just fine doing what I'm doing now, so I'm really not in a hurry. You know, this is a really slow lift hill, but I think that it kind of works for this. Now, how are we looking with excitement? Not that I really care. I kind of want it to be boring. Could be better. Could be worse. I'm okay with it. Let me drag that to there and hit smooth. There we go. Alright. That looks good. And I'm going to go ahead and add the brakes to this. Slap a catwalk on there. And are those on the same side? They are on the same side. Good. I am impressed. No, I'll go ahead and just elongate it the whole length of it. Okay, that's good. And we'll add a very, very small straight section with some drive tires. Actually, no, I'll leave it blank. And then we're gonna add another... that part right there will just be blocks, and the rest of it will be action. Now, normally, I would be like, oh, well, I'll just build an angled slope, but Giovanola didn't do that, so I'm not going to do it either. And we'll shorten it to about there, and your target speed is going to be 20 at 11 meters per second. And that's good. Okay. Actually, how many did I build just there? One, two. I just want that one. Then you're gonna go into that. Alright, that's good. Okay, so now I know at least where I need to line up to. So, where were we? About... here, we're going to have another hill going this way. Thank you. Alright, there we go. Now that I've built the weirdest turn ever, we can start going into the downward helix. That would obviously make people gray out, because that's what they should do. That's what Goliath does. So it only makes sense. Can I make this any bigger? Yes. Autocomplete. Yep, there we go. Giovanola. That's how you do it. I mean, that's really all that you need. I mean, this ride wouldn't have done much. Probably just would have meandered around a little bit more. So you know what? We're gonna ride this now and see how that ended up. Like, I'm not trying to make this like a parody on Giovanola coasters, but this is kind of how they end up. And even with this current layout, like, I'm being very, very generous with how they actually are. Okay, come on. Alright, 1 year later, we are at the top of the lift hill. We're just dragging right now. Yay! Too much to it, and I'm not even gonna do that on screen. I'll do it off screen, and then I'll show it off on the next part, because I'm really tired right now. It's like 1 a.m. and I was like, I'm not gonna put a video up today, and I was like, no, do it, put a video up today. So fine, and this is gonna be Goliath then, because it's a combination of Goliath and Titan. See what I did there? Goliathin. Also, I don't know if I ever showed off the name for what I call this, but it's El Balder Express, because it's El Toro and Balder and T-Express. There's no Colossus in there, because Colossus is actually closed. I mean, like, not for good, but I mean, you can't ride it if you were to go to Hyde Park right now, so yeah, it's closed. Oh! I did some things to this to add for more trains to run efficiently without having to stop, like, right there. Like, oh, look, there it goes again. So, there's now a block section here, and here, and here. And it allows the ride to just run oh so perfectly, and I love it. It just runs so nicely, like... Before, when it actually used to fill up the whole... Oh, Jesus Christ. Oh dear. And, you know what? I'm like Chief Beef? Yay! Chief Beef. I'll need to fix that. But yeah, the line moves really, really nicely now. That's all I was trying to get at. This ride's still... has a crappy queue to wait in, but the ride itself is amazing, and they have this thing timed out so you're not just waiting on the lift hill for it to clear a certain point. You now you just wait in the station where it's a little bit more acceptable. I mean, they have to like do the visual scan and stuff anyway, so it's fine. But yeah, I'm gonna call it a part now that I've built a terrible Giovanola Hyper coaster that's admittedly ugly and the layout sucks, but that's a Giovanola for ya. So there's that. But thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you next time.